Okay, so Vijay sir, you were the first mainstream producer from Malayalam who made this leap into the OTT space. A year later, everybody's doing it. It's become normal now. Do you find all this amusing?
I don't find it because I was sure about it. Because see, when we take a decision at some point of time, it's not about it's not without thinking about why we are taking that decision, right? So last lockdown, when it happened, obviously we have our people in the other, medicine or doctors, or I have friends in IMA. So they were mentioning about how much time it will take the process about the vaccines going to be coming, and how much time normally it can take for a vaccine to be, coming to the market. And so all these factors were considered while taking that decision. And this was explained by me to my association, as well as Amma, as well as Police Association. And after a few days, they gave me wholehearted support, and happy to see that, people are following suit, and, things have not come back to normal. We don't know when it's going to be coming back to normal. So that's the scenario.
You're also one of the fastest producers in the industry. And I'm always amazed by how fast you put your projects together. Has the pandemic in any way impacted the way you work? Has your
not at all. Not at all. I produced 3 films last year. I produced so Home was probably the first movie to be produced to be shot indoor and outdoor with all the pandemic norms and finished shoot in 41 days. Apart from that, I produced a movie called Thirupu with Prithviraj and Indrajit and Saiju Puru, myself, the lead. Apart from I finished a movie with 9 dogs in the lead.
Valati.
So I didn't, obviously, there were government norms and we had tough times and stuff like that. But for me, it was like when Sofi Sujata released, there were questions asked why you could have waited. And I always believe in rotation of money. And that time I gave word to the industry that if when I dilute this movie, as a producer, I'm saying, when I dilute this movie, I can give jobs to another 50, 60 people. There are people who depend on me. There is my staff. There is people in the industry who I repeat for my movie. So these are people struggling or sitting at home without any work. So I'm happy that in the last 3 movies which I shot during the pandemic, I could give jobs to at least, directly and indirectly to at least 60 to 70 people per movie, apart from the artists and technicians. So I never sat quiet. I never sat back during the pandemic. I worked very hard. And that was the first of the movie which I shot during the pandemic.
By now, we all know the synopsis of Home. So, is there a personal factor in that film that compelled you to take on it?
See, I thought it's a need of the hour because this movie was conceived at least 5 years back. Rojan told me this thought at least 5 years back when social media or digital addiction or phone addiction was not at its peak at that time. But I thought that movie had a story to say, the movie had a message to say, and I said we'll do this at some point of time. But it was about the right cast always. So always it's like Sufi Sujata, I waited for at least 3 years to find the right Sujata at that time, and then Aditi landed up. So in this movie, the protagonist was very important. So the movie was written keeping in mind another senior actor, and there were some health issues for that actor, and we couldn't find an alternate, and we kept it on hold. During the pandemic, after Sufi Sujata release, it is a coincidence that, the new generation, especially my son's age, 13, 14, these kids are addicted to gadgets, and we can't complain because they are living on. They are doing their own online classes on the farm. They can't go outdoor for the games. They are deprived of all these things which we would have. See, my son got into high school when the pandemic started. Now he's in the 9th standard. He has not seen school. So he's seeing the school through his phone. So we can't complain. We are caught up in a cash-limited situation where we can't say that you can't be on phone. and also we want them to do something else, but what else can they do? So my wife, one day, while we were having, he was like on phone, he said, this is a time when that story called Home should have been told. So that hit my mind and said, yes, but Rojan had conceived the script 5 years back. And that time, 5 or 6 years back, when there was no Instagram at that time. So all these things had to be rewritten, like according to the times and how things have changed. And but the thread of the movie, the basic message was about the how we ignore the older generation, generation who are technically not, you know, sound, or they might have missed it while the technology grew, or they're not used to the gadgets and all. So that keeping the thread the same, we developed the story according to the new times, and that's how Home was born.
Yeah. How do you look at social media? Because sometimes, you know, it gets very overwhelming, right? And especially in this time. And no, also when a movie comes out.
No, I try to stay away as much as possible, but you know, it's there is no other go. We have to be on social media. It's a, you know, things are changing, and especially during this pandemic, we get updated through social media and stuff like that. Normally, I use it for my movie promotions, and I use it to convey my messages, if any. But I am not that addicted to social media. But obviously, I am addicted to my phone. I know the reality that, you know, my attention span is reducing. See, Home also tells the same story. Like, why Home? Is because we are all living in a virtual home right now. Even if you are home, we are not home. Yeah. That's the message we are trying to convey. Like me, my wife and son is at home, or you, your parents, your kids, everyone is at home, but nobody is at home. We are all living in a virtual home, in our own world, sitting at home. Yeah. This is the message we are trying to convey through the film.
I see. Now you have a part in this film, right?
I play an extended cameo in the film.
Oh, okay. So speaking of your performance, one of your funniest performances was in Janamai 3, and I was kind of disappointed that the film didn't do, you know, the kind of business that, like, as a producer, do you now find that a film like that would have done better on OTT? And,
no, actually, when I conceived the film, there is a business plan for every film. When I conceived the film, I never kept theater in mind. It was a, I know, see, humor is a genre which Malayalis always love. It has, I was sure that it will have repeated audience through OTT and satellite. And it was conceived for that kind of an audience. So theatrical release was not in my business plan, but it is mandatory for a movie to be released in OTT and satellite. It's mandatory that we have to release in theater. So like you said, even yesterday when I was with a few friends at the function, they were also mentioning about the same movie. I'm happy that a movie like Janamai 3, after me having acted in 30 films, you're mentioning about Janamai 3, such a small film. Yeah, I'm happy that you're saying that. That itself shows the success of the movie.
Yeah, because last time in the pandemic, when people were asking me about the kind of films, because everybody was depressed and all that, right? So this was one of the films that I recommended, because nobody does that kind of comedy anymore.
I love taking humor. I'm a, people think I'm a very serious person, but you know, I love humor. I love acting in humor. I'm in comedy movies. I'm basically a fun-loving person.
Do you have any intention to do more of such roles?
We are actually, my next film is with Mithun Vairaval Thomas again, because Aadi 3 is a big movie and cannot be done shot during the pandemic. It's a multi-role film, and so me and Mithun are joining hands again for a light-hearted comedy, which will be shot soon after Onam, and by September 1st we'll be on floors.
Oh, wow. Oh, nice. So, what's the status of Walati? And also, you have announced a project with Mamuti. I'm sure that cannot be made later, right?
Because that's a big budget film, and that is Murli spending it. As of now, he's in the midst of finishing Emburan. So, after that is when he'll get into it. So, by end of next year, we can expect it. And about Walati, the post-production is in progress. And that's a theatrical film. It will be released in probably 5 to 6 languages. It has no, it's a universal film. So So the work is in progress. Probably we can expect by April. And Tirpur also post-production is in progress. And we should be finishing the post-production two months and waiting.
Yeah. Anyway, thank you so much. We'll talk in detail once the film comes out. All the
thank best. You. I am expecting your review. It will be nice tonight. Yeah. I'll wait for your review.
Yeah. Thank you.